As you know, there are some sort of copper windings in every electrical motor. When you connect electricity to them, the motor turns on and starts rotating. To make things more simple and clear, we represent all of these motor windings with three simple symbols like these. The upper ends are shown as U1, V1, and W1, and the lower ends are shown as U2, V2, and W2. What you're going to learn in this lesson is how to reach these winding ends on electrical motors in the real world. Reaching the windings ends on electrical motors is fairly simple. There is a terminal box on every three-phase motor where you can see all of the motor winding ends as terminals. The arrangement for these terminals is the same as I've previously explained for the motor windings, with a small difference. For example, this motor has these three terminals that have incoming power connected to them and are shown as U1, V1, and W1. But these lower terminals here have a small difference compared to the previously discussed winding schematics. In the winding schematics, the lower ends were named U2, V2, and W2. But here, on the terminal box of the motor, the first terminal is W2, the second is U2, and the third is V2. This can be the schematic for the terminal box of a three-phase motor. With these winding ends, if you want to start the motor in star connection, you can connect these three terminals together like before. Now, if you want to start the motor in delta connection, just like you've learned before, you can connect U1 to W2, V1 to U2, and W1 to V2. To limit the current that the motor draws in the startup phase, you need to start the motor in star connection first. When the motor gains sufficient speed, the connection should change to delta. But to do this, obviously you can't wire the terminals in star connection and then change the connection to delta while the motor is energized and running. You need a way to be able to change the connections automatically. For that purpose, you can simply use a contactor. In the next lesson, you'll learn how to change the connection of the motor windings automatically using contactors. That's it for today's video lesson. If you found value in this video, show your love and like this video. That does two things. First, that gives us the motivation to keep making free valuable content for you. And second, it helps other people just like you to find our videos more easily through YouTube. Please subscribe to our YouTube channel if you haven't already done so. That way, each new video will be sent to you as it's published. How would you like to get access to a library filled with top-notch PLC programming lessons, as well as new video lessons delivered to you every week? For more info and free training, go to realpars.com.